A Brooklyn street gang charged with stealing $4.3 million in COVID-19 relief money. Now, I hope they got a chance to spend it, because now these idiots are trying hard not to get convicted. Let's talk about it on the mic. Hello, good people. This is your guy, Mr. Educated, Mr. Communicated, Mr. Free Thinker, coming back at you live once again from the Lone Star State with another edition of the Media Mike Speaks. All right, good people, it is 31 minutes past the hour, and yes, we are the voice of the everyday citizen. All right, good people, these idiots out of Brooklyn, the Wu Gangs, they were called. I think you may have a couple of your, I think, street rappers involved in this. I'm not sure, but some degree of, I would say, high-profile individuals, some affiliated with them. I don't know, you tell me. But they've been charged with pocketing more than $4.3 million in pandemic relief funds, using people's stolen identities to file 1,000 fraudulent pandemic unemployment claims, according to the prosecutor. Now, 11 members of the so-called Wu Gang were accused of filing more than $20 million in false benefit applications, about a fifth of which were approved, and having the payments sent to addresses they control. Now, before I go in on roasting these individuals, I have to say that was a brilliant idea. But it also tells you something about our system too. But it also tells you something about social media and how stupid people are when it comes to that, as in these individuals. Now, prosecutors say, case in point, good people, case in point, said the gang was ultimately caught in part because they posted numerous pictures and videos of themselves online, flashing gang signs and piles of cash, while often standing in front of luxury cars, including Lamborghinis and Mercedes-Benz. Photographs and videos of the defendants posted on public accessible social media pages showed them expressing their allegiance to the Wu Street Gang through hand signs and other means, and flaunting their ill-gotten gains by displaying large stacks of United States currency and standing near luxury vehicles. This is what the investigators wrote in their complaint, in their criminal complaint, but as you can see on the videos, photos, and possibly videos they posted. Now, in May of 2021, several of the accused gang members appeared in a music video on YouTube entitled Trapping, which included lyrics such as "Unemployment got us working a lot," quote unquote, which investigators argued in court papers was a reference to the fraud scheme. 10 of the 11 men, who are all 23 years old or younger, were taken into custody on Thursday and couldn't be reached for comment. It is not clear if they have retained attorneys. Good people, 23 years old or younger. You know what this reminds me of? That movie, A Bronx Tale, starring Robert De Niro. And in that movie, he had a quote. He said, "There's nothing more pathetic in the world than wasted talent." I'm paraphrasing, though, but I'm pretty sure, you know, there's nothing more pathetic in the world than wasted talent. And these young men wasted their talent. Brilliant. Should be on Wall Street, actually, you know, but stupid at the same time. But anyway, let's continue. Prosecutors say that between March 2020 and October 2021, the men got hold of names, birth dates, and social security numbers of 800 people and used them to submit nearly 1,000 claims to New York State's Department of Labor for unemployment benefits related to pandemic assistance programs. Now, I wonder what system they use. How did they get 800 people? So, wow. While many of the claims were rejected, several hundred were approved, and prosecutors say the men had their debit cards containing the benefit payments sent to mailing addresses to which they had access. All 11 men have been charged with conspiracy to commit access device fraud and aggravated identity theft. I'm pretty sure the FBI may be calling on some of them. I would hope so, to use their skills in the other direction. Well, now, I don't know what they will be convicted of, but what, you know, but I know what the charge is. As I stated in the title, you simply just can't fix stupid. As I said before, people, the social media trap is used as a weapon. Now, most of the money that they stole has already gone probably back to the system or back to the people they stole it from. They've repossessed the cars, most likely they'll be sold at auction. So what was the point? See if you can do it? Well, that was achieved. Now you're probably going to get sent away for a while. Wasted talent. Wasted talent. So sad. Anyway, let me know what you think about this story in the comment section below. Feel free to leave your comments if you choose to do so. Until next time, good people, this is your guy, Mr. Educator, Mr. Communicator, Mr. Free Thinker. Subscribe, share, and like to keep me rocking on the mic. Have a good night. I'll understand you soon. It won't be long. Keep on, keep on.